rescued from the U.S. Embassy to Dili by Delta forces stationed at the nearby training grounds of the Timorese Defense Force. All but one of the hostages have been accounted for, though. Continue to voice protest at Japan's formation of an information self-defense force, promising sanctions of both. Responded to General Kellner's announcement of increased U.S. military presence in East Timor with cautious support, justifiably wary of the response from neighboring.
Saulnier Cryogenics Lab, Paris, France, March 30th, 2006, 04, 12 hours. I don't know why I said France like that. Probably because my French took over. Identify Sadono chief mercenary. An enemy agent operating under the alias Mortified Penguin has broken into the Saulnier Cryogenics Lab with a gang of French and Syrian mercenaries. Trace their path of intrusion to uncover their purpose and the identity of Mortified Penguin. Now, greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. Pandora Tomorrow in first person perspective, that is a goddamn mouthful. Now, this mission is going to be a bit of a doozy because most of the times when they shoot one person, all the others in the room automatically know that their comrade has been shot. And yeah, they pretty much raise the alarm. But thankfully, the alarm levels keep dropping with time as well. So that's a good thing. Apart from that, we also need to hide the bodies probably to make sure that the alarms don't keep going off, essentially. But anyway, just to recapitulate, the Darah, an Indonesian extremist group, attacked the U.S. embassy, the newly opened U.S. embassy in Dili, Eastern Timor. And what we found was email communications between an American who goes by the name of Mortified Penguin, or rather the email alias of Mortified Penguin. All we know about him is that he has an American accent, and his last name may or may not be Poindexter, it might just be another alias, and he has a wooden leg. And he wanted to meet Fitsuhadi Sadono in Saulnier Cryogenics Lab. So that's what we're here to find out. As to what exactly they want to achieve together.
Welcome to Paris. You'll have time for sightseeing later.
Thanks, Lambert.
Grim extracted enough from Saulnier's security systems to trace Mortified Penguin's movements. But we don't know why, what he wants, or who he is.
Is he still inside?
Hard to say. The man's cover is rock solid.
Are you saying he's CIA?
If he is, he's under deeper cover than I've ever seen. We've got intel linking him to at least a dozen French-Syrian terrorists.
As Mortified Penguin?
The email alias is all we've got. It's ridiculous, but that's probably the point. Like the smiley face on a cobra's hood.
Lambert's surely got away with words. Now, since we do not have any kill restrictions at this level, I will be killing literally everybody that I come across. And starting off with this lamp here. Come here. Good. This guy's dead. I still do want to take this light out though. So that this guy's in the shadows and will not be discovered later. Now, of course, I will be going up the train. Up the rails, I mean, sorry. And let me just equip my... smoke grenade. Make the next part easier. I'm hoping that this recording turns out fine, otherwise I'm gonna have to do this level all over again. And I must admit that it is a bit of a pain to do this level.
What? What? I thought you said something.
You're jumpy. Calm down.
How long do you think it'll take them to find the Frenchmen?
What do you mean, Frenchmen? We're all Frenchmen here.
I mean the French Frenchmen.
The security guard.
That's one way to do it. No alarms triggered this time around. Let's just take out this tube light and move them into the shadows. Because why not? This is good enough. I mean, if the indicator is blinking, that means that they will not be discovered wherever they're putting them, wherever we are putting them. So we can put them there. Like, it counts in the shadows. Now that I have a better understanding of the flow of this level, it's actually a pleasure to play. I mean, it's more of a tactical shooter now than it was before.
Good, you're in. Grim's daughter suggests first accessing the security terminal on your floor, so she can investigate network activity in the complex.
She can't do it remotely.
No, the important files are off the grid. His case file says the founder was worried about the government stealing his client's files when the apocalypse rolls around.
Paranoia-based security.
That's our mantra.
Good thing that they understand each other. So we can go ahead and use this computer. It won't really give us much. Yeah. Oh, that reminds me. There's like this entire thing about, you know, the founder of Saulnier Cryogenics. What's his name though? Guy Saulnier. Yeah. If you want to like read it, go on. Go on and pause. This is the entire of the text, by the way. Yeah. I hope I provided you with ample time. Sticky shocker, ring gear, fall rounds, smoke grenades, diversion cams. Let's hope we're not catching an alarm right here. What does not make sense?
Security stage increased. Stage 1, flak jackets on.
Alarm stage 1. Sam, don't be detected.
Fisher, you need to be a ghost. You're putting the mission in danger.
Yeah, I thought a lot of that throughout this mission. Just because I was playing it in more of a shooter style. But that's the thing, I mean, despite that guy getting shot, like, despite this guy dying, the other guy immediately knew that we were there. So, if you're gonna kill somebody in this level, you better make sure that you can kill them all at the same time. So what I'm gonna do in the next section is I'm gonna go ahead and use a grenade. Or at least try to. But before that, I'm gonna restore all my health. I think we're done. Yeah. When Sam groans, we're done. I did not want to open this door. I just wanted to switch the lights off and take my grenade out.
Search every inch of the auditorium. We never know.
That did not work out the way I wanted it to.
Security stage increased. Stage 2. Helmet on.
Alarm stage 2. Fisher, if you remain a ghost, the alarm stage will decrease.
I know.
Fisher, we cannot afford any more casualties. One more alarm and the mission is over.
My god. That was difficult. I feel like I might have made it like purposely more difficult than it was. But that was difficult. I feel like these guys are already in the shadows, so we don't really need to bother much. This guy is also in the shadows. The good thing about this level is that, despite the fact that you keep getting alarms, I mean, that failed completely. That plan did not go through as I had intended. But yeah, I can't reach it. There's another satchel here. 556? Yeah, 556. Let me go ahead and reload this because we'll be needing the bullets right now.
Confirmed. The basement is clear. I repeat, basement clear. I proceed now and destroy all the computers.
Fisher, We need those access codes.
And we got shot once more. Good thing that these guys suck at shooting. I mean, I do as well, but these guys suck at shooting more than I do. Should I just... Yeah, might as well. That's all set. Just take out the lights. No need to carry the bodies. Disposable pick, that is nice.
I'm in.
Great work, Fisher. What do we got, Grim?
Let's see. Mortified Penguin cracked their system directories. Looks like all of his attention was focused on the client databases.
Meaning, he was looking for specific frozen dead men. What do the client databases say?
Nothing from here. It's a separate network. Oh my god.
What?
What?
The mercenaries just remote triggered a bomb timer.
Where is it?
The signal is coming from the boiler room, further down the corridor.
Security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
For now. That's one way to avoid alarms, basically. That's all I wanted to avoid alarms, as much as I could. Even though it doesn't really matter because the alarms are more or less going to disappear on their own after a certain point in time. It's like each section has
okay,
got
okay, done.
Well done. Now you can access the database. That's one floor up, and your next objective.
Oh shit. It's really dark there. I mean, I couldn't see anything. Sadono's chief mercenary, eh? So that red thing over there, that's a motion detector. We need to be slow around it. We can be fast right now, but as we approach it, we need to mind our speed. Otherwise, well, it just goes off. And that's not good for any of us. There are three bad guys there, but what I want to do is just kill this guy first. And maybe take this light out. And that's it. That's all I want to do. Now there are other people that we can, you know, go for, but it doesn't really make sense. Our objective is right there. A computer, right over there. Red colored computer. And that's all we really need to access. The locks. Like, picking the locks is something that I found to be exceptionally difficult with the, you know, really? With the controllers, because I did not expect it to be that difficult.
I found the guard on the security cameras. I think you were right. It looks like he's behind that big vault-type door. The label on the monitor says Body Processing Room.
I'm inside the client storage database.
I'm tapped. Taking a look, see? I see at least eight clients Mortified Penguin pulled up in detail.
Anything in common?
All frozen in the last 6 months, and all cheapskates. They all booked economy tickets to the future, just their brains frozen. The low-end storage device is called an ND-133, vacuum-powered refrigeration.
Where did Mortified Penguin hit next?
Limited storage. It's where Saulnier stows all the ND-133s.
That sounds like your next objective, Fisher. Find us some French brains.
I won't promise anything.
Do your best. Details on your opsat.
I wonder if that's, And we basically need to be careful while exiting that room. And can the code piece pop up? Yeah, 2457. 2457. Right, cool. This section is another doozy. Now, something that I don't like about this game is how the first shot always just breaks the glass, even though it's like a 5-5-6 round. It should like completely penetrate and hit the enemy, right? It does not do that. So yeah, it does something like this. And I suppose that's it. There are some ring airfall rounds, and that's a ring airfall round. Looks like a damn smoke grenade. Let me go ahead and drink some of the health potion right here. God damn, that's bright. If it weren't for my shadow, I wouldn't, you know, understand a thing about what's going on right now. Okay, we're done with that. Opening the door, moving slowly. I'm just gonna go ahead and ignore that satchel. Yeah. Now, of course, we need to move slowly. We still do need to move slowly because this bad boy right here is a wall mine, and if you're not careful with it, it's gonna blow up in our faces. Now, typically, I would carry wall mines with me, but in this level there are no shootouts, so except for the ones that we do. So it is more of a something that's not a necessity, essentially. There are two folks here that we have to target.
That's not good. Somebody killed one of our men.
Security stage increased. Stage one. Flak jackets on.
Alarm stage one. Sam, don't be detected.
Be careful, Fisher. Stealth skills are crucial for this operation.
Yeah, playing the only thing that sucks about playing the game this way is the fact that you have to hide all the bodies that you, you know, help in creating. Otherwise, the game will just do a scan every time you leave room, and it automatically, magically just detects stuff for you, like all the people that you've killed, whether or not, you know, somebody actually patrolled into them or not. And another pretty trollish feature that I found in this level is this phone. Now, look what happens when I go right next to it. It rings. And if these guards are conscious at that point in time, it will draw their attention. So if you're here and you're trying to sneak into that room over there, you pass this phone, it's gonna ring. It's gonna alert everybody to the fact that you're right here. Not ideal. Very trollish. Can I go outside? Of course I can't. Anyway. Do I have the code for this? I think I do. But I'm not sure whether... Yeah, 7562. I've got some more health here. Not that I need.
I've got your French brains, Lambert.
So that's what happened to them.
Mortified dumped the clients and took the ND-133.
I guess we can assume he's not CIA. If he's willing to murder.
Murder frozen organs. You can't murder the dead.
Semantics. I think we've got a way to ID the Penguin. The security guard everybody's so excited about? His name is Francois Codebeuf. Our intercepts suggest he got a lucky picture of Mortified Penguin with his cell phone, was wounded, and locked himself inside body processing.
Processing?
Where they pull the brains out of the skull. Introduce yourself to Mr. Codebeuf and get that phone.
Yeah, so here's
security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
Cool. Now, one thing that I've always been wondering is, like, one question that gets posed to us now is, we always thought that this Mortified Penguin fellow was after some kind of brains, but now it turns out that no, he is after, I don't know, not brains. It's basically the boxes that the brains were kept in. Which is quite strange when you think about it. Time to turn this off. Well, it'll definitely be fun to toy around with it and make it target friendly forces. Yeah, it's basically gonna target me as well as when I try to get away from here, you know. Go towards this guy, essentially. I'll be taking down the lights here. Oh wait, there are no lights here, are there? Well, I don't care if it gives me an alarm. Doesn't really matter to me at this point. Sticky shocker. That's nice. That's nice. I do wanna go back to my rifle though. Don't really like many of the options here. Yeah, I'll just stick to this. You know what? Yeah, I wanna use the disposable pick. Since we already have so many of those. And since the enemies can't see us, we can be... well, pretty quick here to do what we want.
I'm at the body processing room, and it looks like you were right. Norman said he wounded the guard, and there's blood on the door handle. Don't stop searching the rest of this dungeon, but I'm gonna need some help to get past this door. It's built like a vault.
Good luck. So this another like health thing over there. We don't really want to go there, so we don't have to deal with this. Wall mine either. That's where we have to go.
Aim at the handle.
That's never gonna open up.
Stop! Stop! It's obviously not working.
What would you suggest?
I'm sure there's some kind of fuel in this place we could use.
Take a look. We'll keep trying here. Maybe if we can't reach the guard, you can cook him.
Don't hurt me, please. I'm just doing my job.
I suppose you are reloading the SC20 key. Huh.
I'm not here to add to your troubles. Are you badly hurt?
No. I'm living, I think. You are?
I'm from the phone company. There's been a recall.
What?
I'm gonna need to take your telephone.
I'm very confused.
Give me the phone, Francis.
So that's Mortified Penguin. Compliment Mr. Kotobuff on his photography.
We got a facial match off CIA databases. Norman Soth, US citizen.
What's that ID code? Does it mean he's an agency asset?
No, it means they don't know.
I'm running him through Echelon. We could have a location on him within the hour.
Great work, everybody. Make yourself scarce, Fisher. Cohen's waiting outside for extraction.
Right.
Right what?
Oh, nothing much. We just need to take care of this for you. And then we'll be back to talk with you some more. You're an interesting fellow. I would like to make a conversation with you for longer. So this is essentially what we need to shoot. We need to shoot that anyway because this thing here is blocking our way. We can't proceed further. So if we shoot this, it opens up the way for us, and it coincidentally also saves that guy. I mean, we can just wait here and let that guy die as well. It's gonna have essentially the same effect. But yeah, since we are good guys, might as well. And nothing else. These guys just die from the damage they take from that thing over there. Tiny little puzzle segment, which doesn't really make sense, but there we have it.
Is there any way out of here besides the door and the air vent?
You are thinking I would still be here if there was?
How did you end up in here?
Who are you? You are not from the phone company.
I'm a penguin hunter. How did you know whose picture to take?
I could tell the bald guy was the chief, and he was the one who killed the others. The Arabs, they would have just tied them up. But the bald man wanted no witnesses. I thought I could take his picture in secret, but my phone beeps when it takes a picture. This is the only place I can hide, so I run here and wait for dawn. Now we both wait, yes?
Yeah, here's the thing. I mean, something that I just realized. Why did this guy address us in English when he's French?
I can't wait for dawn.
I am guessing you turn into a pumpkin.
Now you're getting it.
A pumpkin that kills penguins for the phone company.
Now you're being ridiculous. You better find someplace to hide.
You sure that's safe?
Go away.
You sure that's safe?
Go away.
Right then. I wish you good luck. Especially with that gutshot that you've got going. Wish we could stabilize him, but yeah, we can't exactly do that. The game won't let us, even though I'm pretty sure Sam already knows how to do all of that. So yeah, now that we shot that thing, all the gas is leaking out there, so it's not leaking through here. And we can peek through this optic cable here, but it's not really gonna work. The lock will be jammed. Like, opening the door is not gonna work. And this is cool. Saulnier Cryogenics Lab, Paris, France, March 30, 2006, 05:23 hours. Mission complete. A recovered image of Mortified Penguin matched the CIA record of an agency-trained operative named Norman Soth. Though Echelon was unable to identify Soth as either a friendly or enemy asset, Grim Sorter successfully traced him to a train en route to Nice under the alias Jonathan Poindexter. Poindexter, see? I mean, that's one of his aliases. Now, the thing is, the next level, I don't know whether I'll be able to play it in FPP or not, like in first person perspective, because it has a lot of set pieces that rely on the third person perspective and bodily awareness of where Fisher is, and I lose both of those things for the most part when it comes to, you know, playing the game in the first person perspective. So I'm not sure whether it is going to be possible for me to play this game, play the next level. So I'll try to play it. If it turns out to be unreasonably difficult, I'll just skip it entirely. So anyway, the next time we come back, we'll either be covering train, which is, you know, on route from Paris to Nice, or we will be skipping a level and heading straight over to Jerusalem, which should be comparatively easier. Even though it has stealth requirements, I think it would be a much easier level to complete even with the first-person perspective mod. Not as many set pieces. I mean, there are set pieces, but not as many sections that require us to be aware of exactly where we are. Like, requires to be very precise with our positioning. So, yeah. Until then, thank you. This is it for today. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. And thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time. Take care. Farewell, fellow things.